Our hymn is number 301.
God, come to my assistance. Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Alleluia. O Queen of heaven and of earth, way down by sin we cry to you. Hope of those who refuge seek, hear now our lowly prayer for aid. You are the gate to endless life. Lend gracious ear to us who call. You took away Eve's sad reproach by bringing hope of life to all. Nations shall come and worship you.
It's a feast.
Rejoice, daughter of Zion. Behold, your God is coming to dwell in you. Alleluia. I rejoiced when I heard them say, let us go to God's house.
And now our feet are standing within your gates, O Jerusalem.
Jerusalem is built as a city, strongly compact.
It is there that the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord.
For Israel's law it is, there to praise the Lord's name.
There were set the thrones of judgment of the house of David.
For the peace of Jerusalem, pray. Peace be to your homes.
May peace reign in your walls, in your palaces, peace.
For love of my brethren and friends, I say peace upon you.
For love of the house of the Lord, I will ask for your good.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Rejoice, daughter of Zion. Behold, your God is coming to dwell in you. Hallelujah. Blessed are you, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. If the Lord does not build a house,
In vain do its builders labor.
If the Lord does not watch over the city, in vain does the watchman keep vigil.
In vain is your earlier rising, your going later to rest.
You toil for the bread you eat, when he pours gifts on his beloved while they slumber.
Truly sons are a gift from the Lord, a blessing, the fruit of the womb.
Indeed, the sons of youth are like arrows in the hand of a warrior.
Oh, the happiness of the man who has filled his quiver with these arrows.
He will have no cause for shame when he disputes with his foes in the gateways.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Blessed are you, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. O Lord, you once favored your land and revived the fortunes of Jacob.
You forgave the guilt of your people and covered all their sins.
You averted all your rage. You calmed the heat of your anger.
Revive us now, God, our helper. Put an end to grievance against us.
Will you be angry with us forever? Will your anger never cease?
Will you not restore our life, that your people may rejoice in you?
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and give us your saving help.
I will hear what the Lord God has to say, a voice that speaks of peace.
Peace for his people and his friends, and those who turn to him in their hearts.
His help is near for those who fear him, and his glory dwell in our land.
Mercy and faithfulness have met. Justice and peace have embraced.
Faithfulness shall spring from the earth, and justice look down from heaven.
The Lord will make us prosper, and our earth shall yield its fruit.
Justice shall march before him, and peace shall follow his steps.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. Alleluia. Praised be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
who has bestowed on us in Christ every spiritual blessing in the heavens.
God chose us in him before the world began to be holy and blameless in his sight.
predestined us to be his adopted sons through Jesus Christ.
Such was his will and pleasure, that all might praise the glorious favor he has bestowed on us in his beloved.
In him and through his blood we have been redeemed, and our sins forgiven. So immeasurably generous is God's favor to us.
God has given us the wisdom to understand fully the mystery, the plan he was pleased to decree in Christ.
A plan to be carried out in Christ in the fullness of time, to bring all things into one in him, in the heavens and on earth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. To God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. Alleluia. From St. Paul's letter to the Galatians. When the designated time had come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to deliver from the law those who were subjected to it, so that we might receive our status as adopted sons.
Mode 8.
Beata quae credidisti, quae dicta sunt tibi ad Domino. Cum Christo regnans in aeternum. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior.
For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed.
The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation.
He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit.
He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly.
He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty.
He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy.
The promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
Beata quae credidisti, quedica sunt tibi ad Domino, cum Christo regnans in aeternum. Let us praise God, our Almighty Father, who wished that Mary, his son's mother, be celebrated by each generation. Now in need we ask, Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
O God, worker of miracles, you made the Immaculate Virgin Mary share body and soul in your Son's glory in heaven. Direct the hearts of your children to that same glory.
Kyrie eleison.
You made Mary our mother. Through her intercession, grant strength to the weak, comfort to the sorrowing, pardon to sinners. Salvation and peace to all.
Kyrie eleison.
You made Mary full of grace. Grant all men the joyful abundance of your grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Make your church of one mind and one heart in love. And help all those who believe to be one in prayer with Mary, the Mother of Jesus.
Kyrie eleison.
Pray for Father Nathan, Father Francesco, for all those who've asked for our prayers, for a special intention. For the health of Sister Teresa Maria.
The Brothers Convent for vocations to our community, to religious life, to the priesthood.
Thanksgiving for God's blessings these days, and for continued peace of heart and humility.
You crowned Mary, Queen of Heaven. May all the dead rejoice in your kingdom with the saints forever.
Kyrie eleison.
Pater noster,
qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione, sed libera nos a malo. Let us pray. O God, who made the mother of your Son to be our mother and our queen, graciously grant that, sustained by her intercession, we may attain in the heavenly kingdom the glory promised to your children. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
May the divine assistance be always with us.
And also with our brothers and sisters.
Martyrology of August the 23rd. In 1617, the heavenly birth of Saint Rose of Lima, the first saint of the New World, having desired to consecrate her great physical beauty to God, she took the habit of a Dominican tertiary and lived as a semi-recluse in her parents' garden. Anxious for the salvation of the Indians, for whom she was ready to give her life, she practiced great austerities. She died at the age of 31 at Lima, Peru. Around the year 300, Saint Theonas, Bishop of Alexandria. According to the Arabia Jacobite Synaxis, this saint was educated, religious, and full of kindness toward his neighbor. In his goodness, he built the first church in Alexandria under the patronage of Our Lady. For up to that time, the faithful had been celebrating the holy mysteries in secret on account of the pagans. He excommunicated the heretic Sabellius and refuted his doctrine. Then he died in peace. At Todi in Italy, the year of the Lord 1285, Saint Philip Benzini, 30 years after the foundation of the Order of the Servants of Mary, the Servites, this brilliant young Italian doctor chose to live with the brothers of this new congregation. Later appointed novice master and then elected fifth superior general, he devoted himself unto the day of his death to the interests of the Mother of the Redeemer by organizing his order and by doing his best to settle the conflict between the Guelphs and the Ghibellines. Elsewhere, the heavenly birth of numerous other saints whose names are inscribed in the Book of Life.